Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So from today we are going to start HTML crash course. So before starting what is HTML and all the stuff, let me tell you what are the table of contents that we are going to discuss in the further classes. So as you can see on the screen, these are the four topics that we are going to see in the further classes on this channel. So the first thing is basics of HTML. We will dive into what is HTML, how to use HTML, how to set up HTML in your local laptop, everything. So in the second topic, we will going to be discussing some of the advanced topics of CSS. And in the third topic, we will see the basics of JavaScript and how to integrate JavaScript and HTML. And finally, we will make some projects that will be helpful to you in future. So before going into the first topic, I want to tell you a little information about the web development. So as you can see on the screen, basically a full stack website consists of three parts. So the first part is browser, or also known as front end. This is the part which is visible to us. Like if you go to any website, the UI and all the stuff will be in the browser. So the second part is a combination of web server and database, which is also known as backend. So all these three things work together to make a full stack website. So let us take an example. So as you can see in this website, the portions that are visible to you is front end, like the text, the inputs, the buttons. All this stuff is the called the browser part or front end part. So let's try to log in. So whenever I click login button, so as you can see on the screen, whenever I try to log in with the wrong password, it is telling me that the password is incorrect. So this logic will be calculated in the backend part. So how this website works is, so whenever we click the login button, the Facebook website will send a request to the web server, and the web server will check the login info and the sign up info in the database. So if the both infos are matched, it will send a positive response, else it will send a negative response. So here I entered a wrong password, so that's why it is showing me error. So this is how a full stack web application will work. So now that you have an idea about web development, I will tell you what is the setup that is needed to use HTML in your mobile or laptop. So if you are using a laptop, I will suggest you to install Visual Studio Code from the Google Chrome or any browser that is used by you. So if you are using a mobile, so HTML in mobile is a pretty difficult task, but if you don't have a laptop, I will suggest you to install this decoder app from the Play Store, and you can use HTML in the tab. So now let's start the tutorial on HTML. So HTML means hypertext markup language. So it is not a programming language. A programming language is something that we use logics and conditions to do something, but a markup language is simply a manipulation of something. Like HTML will be compiled in the browser itself. So the browsers will have compilers like V8 engine. So different browsers use different compiler engines to render HTML. So HTML is a combination of tags. So HTML is made up of tags. So tags are nothing but similar to keywords in programming languages like C++, Python, etc. The HTML contains tags. So these tags will be understood by the browser. And whenever we write something between these tags, the browser will understand that it is needed to render the information that is enclosed between the tags. So there are two types of tags available in HTML. So the first type of tag is container tags, and the second type of tag is empty tags. So container tags are something which has both opening and closing tags. So we can render some information between these tags, and the browser will render that information in the browser. So empty tags are something which has only one tag, so these don't have opening and closing tags. So these tags are used to add some features to the container tags. So now let's see the basic structure of HTML document. So before starting HTML, you need to do some things so the browser can understand that you are writing a HTML document. So the first line of code that you need to write whenever you are doing the HTML file is include this line. So doc type HTML. So what do this line does is, so it tells the browser that you are writing a HTML file. So it will make its tools ready to compile HTML. So the first tag, as you can see, is HTML. So this is the root tag for all tags. So whatever you want to include in the HTML document must be inside these two tags, HTML opening and HTML closing tag. So basically HTML tag is divided into two sections. So the first section is head tag and the second section is the body tag. So the head tag is invisible to us. So it performs some metadata operations on that site. So whatever you write in the body tag is visible to us. So whatever you write on this body tag will be rendered in the browser itself. So in the next section, we will see how we can start our first HTML file. So now in this section, we will see how we can start writing HTML in our local laptop. So as you can see, I have installed Visual Studio Code on my system. So open the Visual Studio Code on your laptop and click on new file. So it will give you a new file. First of all, simply save it. So I will save it on my desktop. So I will give it a name of index.html. So if you want to create a HTML file, the file name must extend with .html extension. So let me save it. So as you can see on the desktop, the file icon is replaced with my browser. So I'm currently using Microsoft Edge as my default browser. So the icon is Microsoft Edge. So whenever I try to open this, it will be opened in the Microsoft Edge browser. So this is how HTML works. So HTML will be rendered in the browser itself. So let's see some of the basic tags that are available in HTML. So as you can see on my left side, I have my Visual Studio Code, and in the right side, I have my file working on in the browser. So as I told you earlier, before writing any document, HTML document, you need to include some of the predefined parts. So in Visual Studio Code, we have a nifty trick called emmet abbreviations. So simply press the exclamation mark and press enter. So the Visual Studio Code will automatically give you the boilerplate that is required to start the HTML file. So we will remove these. So as you can see, it gave us a doc type HTML tag and head tags and body tags and enclosed between the HTML tag. So now I will write a basic text, hello world, in the body tag. And I will save it and I will refresh in the right side. So as you can see on the right side, whenever I wrote hello world in my body tag and saved it, and whenever I refresh the browser, it is dynamically changing here as well. So this is how HTML works. So now let's see some of the major tags that we will be using in the HTML in further classes. So the first tag that you need to learn is heading tag. So heading tags is simply but a text that is rendered with a big font weight. So headings, there are six type of headings in HTML. So they are ranging from H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. So among these, H1 is the largest heading and H2 is the subheading and H3 is somewhat smaller than H2 and H6 is the smallest of all. So we will see them in action now. So as you can see, I wrote hello world in my left side. And currently this is how it looks. So now I will wrap the hello world in the H1 tag. So I save it and I refresh the browser. So as you can see, it is now bold and a lot bigger than previous. So this is the H1 tag. So let me do it for all tags so that you will get a better idea. So H2, H3, H4, H5, and finally H6. So I will save it and refresh here. So as you can see on the right side, this is the biggest of all. So H1 is the biggest and H6 is the lowest. So try to observe the fact that all these headings are in bold, means the font weight is bold. So in the next section we will see paragraph tags. So now we will discuss paragraph tag. So a paragraph tag is simply used to display a large amount of information. So it is quite opposite to the heading tags. So it will be in normal case, it is not in bold. So now we will see how we can use paragraph tags in our body. So to simply write a paragraph, keep a p tag. So whatever you write will be rendered as a paragraph tag. So I will write, "Hello guys, this is my first HTML document." I will save it and refresh it. So as you can see, it is rendered in the small case, and also the font weight is much smaller when it compared to the heading. So this is the paragraph tag. So the next tag that I want to discuss with you is link tag. So link tag is nothing but it is used to redirect from the given website to any other website. So to include a link tag in your website, you need to use an anchor tag. So that is A. So it contains a parameter called href. So href is nothing but after clicking this link to what website you want to redirect the user. So I want to redirect the user to facebook.com. So I will copy the URL and simply paste it on the href. So I will write between these A tags, I will write click here, and I will save it on the body tag. So I will refresh now. So as you can see, there is a click here with a small underline. So observe, whenever I'm hovering my mouse on this, it is giving me a cursor. So let me click on this. So as you can see, we are redirected to the Facebook website. So this is how the link tag works. So the next basic tag that we are going to discuss is image tag. So basically we can render images in two ways. So we can render local images and also online images as well. So local images are those which are there in your laptop or mobile, and online images are those which will be in the cloud. So we will be seeing how to use this both. So to use an image in your HTML document, you need to enclose it in image tag. So remember, image is an empty tag, so it doesn't have opening and closing tag, as we don't want to write anything between these images. So it's simply an empty tag. So it has a parameter called src. So src is nothing but the image that you want to display. So whatever the image that you want to display, you need to give its address. So for example, let's start with an online image. So I will simply get this Facebook icon and keep it in my src. So I will save it. I need to save it in the body tag, right? So I will save it in my body tag and save the file and refresh the browser. So as you can see, the Facebook logo is now visible on our website as well. So this is how the online images work. So if you want to decrease the width or height, you can give as extra parameters. So width equals to 100. So let me save it and refresh. So as you can see, the now image is shrink to 100 pixels of width. So this is how online images work. So now we will see how we can load a local image in our HTML document. So go to the file manager and right click on the file that you want to display, click on properties, go to security and copy the file path. Now simply keep an image tag, and in the src section simply paste the path that you have copied and save it and refresh the browser. So as you can see, it displayed the image. So as you can see, the image is cutted towards the width. So I will decrease the width of the image. So width equal to 200. So save it and refresh. So as you can see, the image now is shrunk to 200 pixels. So this is how NMS tag work in HTML. So the next basic tag that I want to discuss is button tag. So a button is nothing but it is an action performing object. So whenever the user click on any button, it needs to perform some calculation with the backend part. So in this, you know, we will see how we can create a button in the HTML. So to simply create a button, simply keep the button tag. So it is a container tag, and what is the text that you want to display with the button. So I will simply keep it as submit. I will save it and I will refresh. So as you can see, there is a submit button in the right side. So we can perform some tasks on click of this button. So with using JavaScript, we can do those things. So this is how we can create a basic button tag. So the next basic tag that I want to discuss is input tag. So as the name suggests, the input tag performs action to take some input data from the user. So for example, there are some websites like enter email, enter passwords. So those will be in the input tags. So we will see how we can create an input tag. So to create an input tag, simply keep input. So remember, it is also an empty tag, which means it doesn't have any closing and opening tags. So I will simply save it and refresh here. So as you can see, I got a box where I can type some information. So this is the input tag. For example, if you want to display some optional message inside the box, like what is this box is for, like enter email, enter password. To do that, we have an option called placeholder. So I will write the placeholder as enter email, and I will save the file and I will refresh. So as you can see, whenever the text is empty, it will show us enter the email. So after I entered any letter, it will disappear. So when the text is empty, it will display enter email. So this is how the input tags will work in a HTML. So that's it guys for this video. So in the next videos, we will be discussing some more HTML tags, and we will be jumping into the CSS, how to include CSS with HTML. So I hope you understood these basic tags of HTML. So drop a like if you understood, and comment with a positive response.